Time somebody said Gordo, so he tagged me with it. I have no idea where he pulled that out of, but says you're Hendo from here on out, and that's what I've been.
A very, very hungry Montreal Canadiens team. It's no secret. Last two games, they got beat bad. What do you see in them, and what do you think you have to do in the next two periods to beat them?
Well, they pretty well bring the same thing to the table every night. They work hard, and they're a really strong defensive team. And I think it really helped us to go out and get the first goal and get the lead. And hopefully they'll try and open it up, and we can get some more opportunities from them.
Tommy Soderstrom, interesting type of goalie. I can't quite define his style. Maybe you can define it for me.
Well, it's funny, I've been playing in Denver for the last 4 months, and Tommy Salo, another Swedish goaltender, is down there, and they have similar styles. They really follow the puck closely, and they get down and cover a lot of the net, and they don't give up too many rebounds, and I don't know what the mystery is, but they sure keep the puck out of the net.
Bloody good to see you again. Hope you're around for a long, long
Claire Garden. The Panthers have never won there, and Mike Richter tried to keep it that way. First period, Rangers physical play. Kevin Lowe rides Jody Hull into the boards. Then Jeff Bookaboom on Jeff Lindsay. Bookaboom again on Lindsay. Hard-hitting period number one at Madison Square Garden. And there is no score after one period of play. Rangers with 14 shots on John Van Beesbrook. Meanwhile, at the Ottawa Civic Center, first period, Senators work the puck around the boards. Kerry Huffman the shot. Troy Murray deflects it in. Ottawa with a 1-0 lead shortly after. Hartford with the pressure on Don Beaupre. Darren Turcotte around the net for the wraparound. Game tied at 1. Jeff Sanderson has scored his 9th goal of the season. And right now, the Whalers with a 3-2 lead over Ottawa after one period. The Islanders play Washington later this week. Philadelphia leads the Capitals 1-0 in period number 1. Elsewhere in the National Hockey League, an 8:30 start. Dallas and Winnipeg at 9:30. Edmonton squares off against Calgary. 10:30, San Jose and Vancouver, and Chicago and Los Angeles. The big game in the NBA tonight is in Orlando as the Magic are playing host to the Knickerbockers. As we take a look at the scoreboard, first quarter, Orlando with an 18-16 lead over the Knicks. Shaquille O'Neal back in the lineup after his one-game suspension. We'll have Knicks highlights on the post game. When we come back, Jim and Ed have first period stats and highlights. The Islanders with a 1-0 lead over the Canadiens after one period of play. There we go as Jigs and Ed rejoin us with first period stats and highlights. Take it away, Jigs.
All right, Bob, we're going to get right to the scoring summary, which will show Ray Ferraro getting the only goal of the game thus far. His 11th of the season with assists to Flatley and King coming at the 9:44 mark. Montreal didn't get a shot on goal when they had the man advantage. The Islanders had a power play later in the period and don't get anything going on that. But here's where they do get it going, and we get it going for you for your Jeep Eagle dealer.
Good work down low. Ray Ferraro, Flatley, King, all in motion. And then Ray Ferraro takes the pass here from Flatley. Held Tugnut until he was able to go to the backhand.
Ferraro, goal number 11. Here's another look at it.
That was Ray Ferraro. That's Flatley down there using his feet, stick, whatever. And then that nice little backhand by Ray Ferraro.
The goal at 9:44, and the New York Islanders have a 1-0 lead over the Montreal Canadiens. The Canadiens had some chances of their own in the period, however.
Sometimes dumping the puck in, a lot of people say, why do you do that? Well, if you do it right, it comes off the backboard in the right position, you get that kind of a play at the net, like having a man standing down there.
And Bure trying to tee up a rebound, it didn't work. 1-0 Islanders.
That's non-commercial use of our audience. Any publication, reproduction, retransmission, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this game without the express written consent of the Islanders and Sports Channel is prohibited.
The only goal in the game scored by that man, Islanders number 20, Ray Ferraro. He's ready to take the face-off against Kirk Muller of Montreal. Recky to the right, Domfus to the left of Muller. Ferraro is flanked by King on the left side, Flatley on the right. That's Derek King getting into the Montreal zone, and his centering pass went off his stick. Brisebois on to Muller, to Domfus. Muller moves in. Domfus fired one high that comes bouncing off the glass, but stays in the zone until Molotov cleared it. This is Patrick Flatley. Dropped it back. Gary King went to the puck. Can't feed it to Molotov, who had jumped in. The Canadian Mark Recchi leads the rush into the Islander zone. Dropped it back. Molotov lifted the man's stick but couldn't control it, and then Brisebois got it right back to where Molotov had gone and went very quickly to that spot. Ray Ferraro with one that's up high and grabbed.
little flip shot. I guess a test shot for Ron Tugnutt. Something that I was watching for in the first period. Of course, we got to see Ray Ferraro score a goal. Doc Demare. Wow, keep it going, yeah. Skate, work hard. Don't tear your sweater, boys. But I was watching Molokov, Jiggs. He seems to be into this hockey game. He carried the puck a lot. He was up and down. He was using his skating ability that so often he doesn't use. But he used it in the first period, and he's used it here in the...
third line is that of Travis Green in the middle with Steve Thomas and Marty McGinnis on the wing. J.J. Daniel moves the puck toward Petrov. Mouth got a chunk of him, and Vasky comes over, throws it around the boards in his own zone. Out by Popovic, shoots from the... and now an interference penalty is called. Dean Chenault goes to the penalty box on that signal from Paul Dvorsky.
Islanders make a mistake, but they don't have to pay the big price. Soderstrom comes up with a nice stop. Watch his feet. It looked awkward. He made the save, though, and here the Islanders leave the front of the net open. Boom, both feet moving forward. Kicks out a beautiful rebound. The Islanders are able to get a hold of it, but down by the net on DiPietro, a penalty. There's the backhand shot, the kicking save. DiPietro gets his helmet knocked off, held up by Dean Chenault.
Second power play of the night for the Montreal Canadiens, both as a result of penalties to Chenault. Muller centers for Recchi and Domfus, while the Islanders have McGinnis and Turgeon as the penalty-killing forward. It's Matthew Schneider playing it around the board. Taken by Vincent Domfus, looked to Racine at the blue line, but elected not to give it to him. Recchi now centers, and that's picked out of the air and brought back by Pierre Turgeon. Turgeon guides it deep into the Montreal zone. Racine goes back in the net for it. Racine pulled back from McGinnis, works it on to Matthew Schneider. To Kirk Muller. Muller taken to the boards there with Luongo on him. Schneider in deep has headed back to Muller. To the point, nobody there. Schneider, the defenseman who normally would be there, was the one who had given Muller the puck.
That's communications, Jake. That's why players should be talking to each other. They should yell to each other so that they know where we are.
Mark Recchi swings to the right side. Racine dumps it into the corner. Muller with it, back of the net. Taken off the puck, and it's played up off the glass by Vasky. Canadians able to hold it in. Tom Cruise to Schneider. His shot is a quick save and a beaut off the pads of Connie Soderstrom. McGinnis lays it down the ice.
That's two fine stops by Tommy Soderstrom.
Here's Avery Sane clearing the zone, but Flatley is back and has given it to Dennis Vasky. Drop that in off Racine. The crowd chanting, Tommy, Tommy. A sign of affection. Flatley is knocked down away from the puck, and Matthew Schneider is being sentenced for interference.
Often we've talked, and I have said, the Islanders are not playing a smart hockey game. Matt Schneider is not playing a smart hockey game for the Montreal Canadiens. A chopping cross check there. Boom. I guess it was more of a push from behind. You wouldn't get a penalty for that if you were at even strength. Here's the shot by Schneider a moment ago. Matt Schneider with a beautiful shot. Good kicking save by Tommy Salo. Tommy Salo, sure. Tommy Soderstrom still talking about and thinking about Tommy Salo, who is, I guess, the International Hockey League Player of the Week.
Yeah, up there with the Denver Grizzlies. And a 1.00 goals against average last week. In three games, was it? Great week, obviously. Third time this season that Tommy Salo has been named the International Hockey League Player of the Week. We've got some four-on-four hockey for the next 23 seconds. Canadians have dumped it in. Derek King is back for it. Vasky fell as he went to the end boards, but it's moved on to Ray Ferraro. Back to Gord Denine, who steps over center, puts it in the far corner. Ferraro after it, bumped Briefois away from the puck. Headed back by the Islanders, but outside the line. Now Chenault is released from the penalty box. The Islanders with the extra attacker. Ferraro's got the puck. Moves in, slides it to King, and Tugnutt makes the stop. Derek King comes out in front, waiting for his teammates to make the changes here. Now he feeds it back, but away from Molokov. And Soderstrom is well out of the net to move it on to Vladimir Molokov. The Canadians changing up their penalty killers. J.J. Daniel clears the puck toward center, bounces on Brune. A minute remaining in the penalty time against Matt Schneider. To Bigman Coffey. Up ahead to Thomas, who is checked. Coffey steps over the line. Gave it right back to Thomas. To Molotov. Into Thomas. Lee Thomas. Deeper to Turgeon, who comes out of the corner. To Thomas at the side of the net. Backs away. Centered. Coffey's got it. Bigman Coffey sets up the point man. Bob Beard. Back into the corner. Coffey has it now. Looking to move, the puck does. Turgeon gets choked off in front, and out comes Daniel. On to Brune. Brune across the line, land to the front of the net. Brune's pass is blocked by Molotov, who chases it. He races down the left wing board to center ice. Across the Montreal line. Turgeon handles it. The pass into Palfi. Right across the front of the net with that play. Vincent Domfus forces the Canadiens, or the Islanders, I should say, all the way back as he gets the Canadiens out of trouble, and it also kills off the penalty to Schneider. Two shots on goal on the power play for the Islanders, but still a 1-0 game. Turgeon has dumped it in from center ice. Dugnut holding it up. Both teams have finished their player changes. Muller's relay to Domfus missed him. Brisbois back in the Montreal defense. Give it to Racine, who turns right back to Brisbois. Nice to the right side where Mark Recchi dumps it into the Islander zone. Moves it out, using the boards, moves it through Marty McGinnis as it turns out. Daniel drops back to Green moving in. Daniel to Muller. It's Muller. It's paddling through the center ice zone. Flips it in from the Islander blue line. Patterson to play it here to the corner for Benoit Hogue. Hogue lifts it up the boards. It's held in the zone by Popovic and will be brought outside the blue line.
92, Vladimir Molotov. Well, just when I get to saying that, Bob Beers breaks them up.
Got to get the tenors over with the bases, or away from the bases, or whatever. Get the choir boys set up there. 1-0, Islanders leading the Canadians. Play at the Islander blue line. Popovic slams it in deep. And all the way around toward Mike Keane. Puts it deeper to the corner. Keane shutouts with Oliver Petrov, and that freed the puck for Thomas. Back to Vasky, who comes to center and dumps it in well wide of Ron Tugnut. Tugnut decides to cover it as he saw Thomas racing in. And some jostling, Daniel and Thomas. Nothing too serious developing here. Four-game road trip for Montreal that started last night in New Jersey with a 6-1 loss. Goes to Washington for a game on Saturday and one in Buffalo on Sunday. And they stay out on the road for the entire duration. The one guy that's accepting it but not happy about it is Matt Schneider.
There's the puck dumped in. Tugnut looked back and he saw Thomas on top of him quickly. Held the puck and see the pushing and shoving. Daniel.